In courses 1 and 2, we value assets by discounting their cash flows at some discount rate. In all these problems, I gave you the discount rate to use. Now, we will learn how to calculate this discount rate. What does the discount rate depend on? A key determinant of the discount rate is the risk of the cash flows that we are discounting. Recall from course 1 that the discount rate or opportunity cost of capital is the rate of return we could obtain by investing in a project with similar risk to the one we are valuing. We will see in this module that the higher the risk, the higher the rate of return we should expect to obtain. Let's consider a simple example to fix ideas. Suppose that you can buy any of 2 assets. One of them guarantees a payment of $100 next year. The payment next year of the other asset can vary. Sometimes it will be higher than 100, and sometimes it will be lower than 100, but on average, let's say that it will be 100. Answer this question intuitively. For which of these assets would you pay more? If you are like most people, your answer is that you are willing to pay more for the asset that guarantees the $100. This attitude toward risk is called risk aversion. Now, let's follow a more formal approach using the concept I've just mentioned. As we have been doing in this course, we compute the value of each of these 2 assets with the present value formula. That is, each asset is worth $100 discounted to today. The difference is that we use a different discount rate. We use a higher discount rate for the asset with the riskier cash flows. Why? Because as I told you before, the opportunity cost of capital is higher for the riskier asset, since the return we can obtain for an investment with higher risk is higher than the return we can obtain for safer investments. The key point is that if we use a higher discount rate for the riskier project, the value we obtain for it is lower, just as our intuitive answer indicated. One comment before we continue. Although not absolutely necessary, some familiarity with probability, especially the concepts of expected value, standard deviation, and correlation, will come in handy for this module.